Hello, my name is Yulia Olkhovskaya. This work was done with my PhD advisor Gergely Neu. And this work is on adversarial linear contextual bandits. So here we study standard contextual bandit problem, which is just a sequential game between the learner and the environment. And here at each time step, the nature reveals the context vector generated from some distribution. And this distribution is fixed, but is unknown to the learner. And the learner observes this context vector and chooses one of k actions. So independently of that context vector and independently of the chosen action, the adversary picks a loss function, where the loss function is just a mapping from the set of context and the set of actions to the set of real values. And at the end of the round, the learner suffers a loss according to the current context and to the chosen action. So the goal of the learner is to minimize regret. And here regret is the difference between the cumulative loss of the learner and the cumulative loss of the best policy. Here, and where the policy is a mapping from the set of the context to the set of the actions. And the best policy is the policy that achieves the minimum cumulative loss for the given sequence of losses. In our work, we focus on the setting where the loss function is a linear function of the context. So the contextual bandit problem was studied for different settings. So for the setting where the loss is generated in ID way, there are efficient algorithms that for both ID context and adversarial context has a regret square root of dkt. So for the case where the adversary is allowed to choose a context and also chooses a loss function, it was shown that no learning is possible in that setting and that the regret can be as much as big as possible. And for the setting where the context generated an ID way and the loss is generated by adversary, there were a lot of works and so among them, there is a famous XP4 algorithm that has regret square root of kt times log n, where n is the size of the policy class. So this algorithm assumes that we have a finite policy class from which we can take the best policy. And the regret is minimax optimal, as we can see here, but the algorithm itself is not computationally efficient because it has to store weights for each policy in that policy class. So also in this setting, there is Bistro++ algorithm that has regret t to the third. So this is slightly worse, but this algorithm is Oracle efficient. And both of these algorithms, they don't restrict to linear loss functions. So what we want to study here is that, is it possible to do to perform better in the setting where the loss function is the linear function, and but where the comparator policy class can be infinite. So for this setting, our answer is yes, and we provide the algorithm that has regret of order of square root of t for the setting where the loss function is linear and chosen by adversary, and the context is generated from some distribution. So the algorithm is based on XP3 algorithm, and we call our algorithm lim XP3. So it maintains weight for every action at each time step, and computes the distribution of the action by using these weights. To estimate the distribution, it constructs the estimates on the losses from the previous time steps. And so in the core of the estimate, we have an action-centered covariance matrix, which computes the following. So this is just expectation of x transpose times the indicator that for the given context, our current policy will play action A. And so the estimate is a modified version of least squares estimate for just one point on-point observation. And so this type of estimates will be used for linear bandits. And so this is the estimate. And for this estimate, you can easily check that this is unbiased. But here we have this specific covariance matrix, which is not very easy to compute. So we have to estimate that. And the question is how to estimate this covariance matrix. So the idea of the estimate is based on Neumann series. And we assume that we have access to sample vectors from the distribution of the context. And here, xk is such a sample. So from these samples, we can construct matrices B, which is just x times xc transpose times the indicator that for this sample, our policy will play action A. And using these matrices, since they are sampled independently, we can approximate the powers in the Neumann series by the products of these matrices. And here it's, so since, as I said, the samples are independent, then the expectation of this estimate of the inverse of covariance matrix will be, will give an unbiased estimate of this, of that matrix. And here we truncate this estimate to make it computationally feasible. And after that, this gives us a finite estimate for the algorithm for the case of linear losses. In our work, we also study the setting where the loss function is just a nearly linear loss, a nearly linear function. So we, more precisely, we assume that the loss function can be written as the sum of the linear function plus some arbitrary function of the context. And for that setting, if you assume that this nonlinear part of the loss is a function that is uniformly bounded by epsilon for every context for each action, then there is, we provide an efficient algorithm that gives a regret of the following order, which consists from two terms. One term is of order square, oh, sorry, t to the third, and the other term is epsilon square root of dt. So the algorithm, again, is based on xp3, but we cannot use the previous estimate now because it will cause a huge bias. So the new estimator is the following. So again, it's least squares for one-point estimator, but now we replace the previous action-centered covariance matrix by just a covariance of the context. So there are several open problems regarding this result. So first, is that term epsilon square root of dt, is it optimal? So this is a question. So what is known is that for the setting of linear bandits, for a large number of actions, no linear bandit algorithm can remove this term, which is epsilon times square root of dt. But it's also known that for the case of ID losses, this term can be improved from the to epsilon square root of kt. So which can be a big improvement for a small number of actions. And so the question, if we can replace this d to the minimum between the number of action and d. And the other question, of course, regarding the first term, and can we, so this is an open problem, if we can, if there is an algorithm that has a regret square root of t instead of t to the third. Or if we can change this to the current algorithm. So this is all. Thank you.